Hi, in lesson 6, we have created a 3D cuboid projection but cannot change the size. In lesson 7, let's see how we can adapt the size of the projection to the parameters in the dialog. In our BYB file that we created in lesson 5, we created parameters for projection length, projection width, and projection height. These parameters can be accessed in building element. Simply call the parameter name from the building element. Then access the value property. Similar to other parameters, run the tool again. And now we can control the size of projection by parameters in dialog. That works fine. However, we still write all our code in function create element. It's not well organized. It's hard for us to manage and change the code for the further development. Instead, we should create a class, then you can put all the codes to create models into this class. For initialization, you can input build element and doc as arguments. For now, let's leave it empty. Then we can create a method to create foundation model. Move code to create foundation into this method. We need building element for the argument. And this method returns a model element 3D class. In create element function, we will create instance of the class. Then return the method createFoundation with the building element as argument. Right, it still works fine. For now, we only have one method to createFoundation model. But how about if we have another model, such as a column? We cannot just call the method createFoundation here. What we need is a method to create our models. This method will return a list of element models. Create an empty element list and return it. To put the foundation to the list, just call the method and append to the list. Similar with column. That works fine, but in some cases, you don't want the elements list appended to the model of a method for some reason. So I prefer to return list than the model element. Then we extend the element list. In this case, if you want to ignore the model, just return the empty list. Let's call the createModels method ingrayElement function. Note that it already returned a list, so please delete the brackets. Run the tool again to make sure that it works fine. Thank you for watching my video tutorial. I highly encourage you to subscribe our channel for more videos.